Thanks for giving me shock, game. I'm getting an elemental weapon. Well, I had to weaken my build by going electric weapon, but that's what happens when the game won't roll it for you.
Thank you.
I forgot to use my marking. Oops. Decent pick. Okay, so I'm going to do the breakdown of the build now rather than at the end and while I'm playing. So, blast minigun, the DPS on it is fairly abysmal if you compare it to any other weapon. Bounce and pierce is interesting on it. because it does let it just kind of bounce around rooms and hit multiple targets, which is kind of cool. Buckshot is always just funny on it. I don't like Buckshot in general, as you guys know, but it's funny to have 1,000 flying little wasps buzzing around doing absolutely nothing, I guess. The best thing going for it is probably just the clip size, because it does mean that you can eventually kill things in a clip, it just takes a long time. As strong as it's looking like it is at the moment, a lot of it is the build. Obviously shock isn't the strongest, but electro sparks is a very strong perk in general, and when you compare it with electro blaster, it just gets stronger. Most weapons will work with it because it's the perks that are working, not the weapon. On top of that, obviously you've got drum and watering can. Drum's amazing, it's one of my favorite items in the game, to be honest. Watering cans just lets you get the stuns quicker. It's not amazing, but it's nice and cheap. Bonzo tree is obviously amazing. Then credit card is just extending your clip size a lot of the time. French fries is letting us, well, French fries plus Bonzo tree is letting us get our sparks up more often, because we're resummoning the bots to fill up the sparks. Everything else is just kind of useful. The reload from hand gripper and olive oil is always a nice combo. I don't like either of the items that much on their own, but when you've got both of them together, it's almost noticeable. So yeah, we'll see if we can finish the run. Something else that I said as well is one nice bonus of this build, and because it's bouncing and lock-on, is that you just don't have to aim. You just walk into a room and spray and everything will eventually die. The main problem is the part of the conversation, the part where I'm having to say eventually, it's just got low DPS. And it relies fully on Bonsai Tree or a build which can auto-crit realistically. fingers crossed we get a bit of royale, because Uncle Doom's going to be a pain in the ass with this build. GG.